So the project in the Ecology Lab, they has the students doing field work, working on permanent plots. These plots have been here for the past 5 years, and every fall that we have the ecology class, they get grouped in groups of, in teams of four, and each one of them gets assigned a plot, and they come here and they have to sort of like monitor the plots every year, right? And what we look for is, number one, what they have to reset the plot from the winters, and then for every tree that is part of the plot, they have to inventory every tree and indicate what the species name is, what is the diameter at breast height, what the height of the tree is, and then they use that to extrapolate a value of biomass and carbon value for that particular tree, so that at the end of the day they get an idea of how much carbon does this absorb, right, on any given year.
So we started with having assigned plots, 20 by 20 meter plots, and then we're doing a lot of demographic information on it. So the trees, where they're located, how dispersed they are, what their identification is. And now we're doing soil to find out how much water goes in, what type of soil we have, and if it relates to the region that we live in.
And so at the end of the semester, they end up with they have to do an oral presentation on their project. The project is unique. They choose the topic they want to pursue. Some students want to understand how a forest like this compares to a similar forest, but that is located in Pennsylvania, which is a slightly different microclimate. So they can ask all kinds of questions. And my job is to kind of like effectively mentor them through the process to arrive to a place where they can present the data and tell the story of their project. And obviously all this is sort of like connected to a global issue, and so we talk about climate change, we talk about how climatic conditions are changing, how does that affect biome geographical distribution, how does it affect species composition, ability of a forest to handle the kind of CO2 that is in the atmosphere, are there really effective sinks on Earth that are sort of like compensating for some of the anthropogenic effects of CO2 accumulation. So it's kind of like, I try to kind of cover what are the more contextualized topics that hopefully make them a more conscious citizen, not just knowledgeable in ecology in general, but knowledgeable about the importance of the environment, conservation and preservation of this very old and beautiful forest that we have in this region of the country.